I can never forget my first visit to Leeds. That was in October 1978, when I went there with the famous, the inimitable, and Honorable Louis Bennett Coverley, affectionately known as Miss Lou. Yes. Well, she's passed now, but it was something that we went there, we performed in Come Home to Jamaica, and that was a tourist promotion to invite West Indians and Jamaicans in particular to come home and come celebrate and spend time with us. Yes, man. And we performed at the Polytechnic Institute, I think, and it was something else. And I gather that it is because of this performance, it spurred the Jamaica Society of Leeds to find them own a place. And it manifested as the Jamaica House. Yes, a place where they themselves can feel, or well, I should say, uno can feel proud that uno bring up uno friends and so on, and dignitaries and big neck people from Jamaica to come and them feel proud to that uno have this place. And I have had a great opportunity of being part of that, because it's because we come there and uno never really have no for how we that uno say, well, we have to buy something and uno buy it. So we feel proud that I am part of the history of Leeds. Yes, 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 yes. So now I just want to I remember people like Travis Johnson, Counselor Norma Hutchinson, then you have Mrs. Reed and Mr. Barrett. They are not with us now, but I just want to ask and reassure the young people them that it is their shoulder on a stand upon, and on if they keep the light of success burning bright, because you know them work hard for it. It is out of all of this now, man, it start to reminisce and, you know, and I say, I wonder how Jamaicans and other West Indians who leave the warm Caribbean to go live in a them cold climate day, how them think about Christmas, if them ever sit down and, you know, reminisce about how Christmas was in the old days in their countries. And but no one to ask anybody remember Chenille spread. That's it, they say. That only come out in a Christmas time and maybe Easter, you know. And you see when you go up on the bed, you can't go near the bed, you know. And well, for more than or two reasons. You can't go near the bed because your mother don't want you to sit on pan and she needs spread. And two, if you go sit on pan it, depending on the kind of material we have, and the whole light dirty up with the dust to come out. Then if a dust are four, come off of the she needs spread. After that, master, it wrap up back, it wash and wrap up and put in a bag with camphor ball. So camphor, where you use camphor now? No mat, no got trouble, your shin is spreading up. Yes, man. Now, Christmas again, them have the doily, you remember doilies? Doily put in the cabinet. I mean, me tell you, no, cabinet was something of a status symbol, you know, and everybody did have cabinet. So when we did have a table and we put the cup and sauce and we two plate them pan it, just take you up same way anyway. So Christmas are come, you take off, you wash the table cloth, I put it back on. So my nice, lovely linen material, and then wash it and then starch it and then high on the man and put it back and white like crimson, white, crimson red, white like snow. And then now them put her back, them crackle pan it, and in the cabinet now them clean out the cabinet and then change it daily. And let me tell you something, what is the amazing about that the cabinet there, you know, you see the sitting them in that cabinet, they not use, you know, them only go fish them the pan show. So sometimes them get so whole that when you wash them, some of them broke and all kind of things, you know. Yes. Yeah, but you put them back in the cabinet and the cabinet clean and pretty, glass wiped down, and you take newspaper and you rub glass and it clean and nice and shine, man, when people are tea. And you remember Wagan? Wagan was the forerunner for whatnot. Yes, man. And Wagan, no. Wagan was the top part. Fi crackery and all them things, the pretty things, you know, and the bottom part, I feel like a grocery. And some people did so, me know if I mean them, me not careful, they usually get key, lock, fi lock it, so that the people then can go in, they go teeth out, not nice. So, yes, that was nice. Now, Christmas that time, fi gungo peas, rice, and peas, you know, man. Yes, man, so you come up there, get your gungo and your shell gungo. Some people make a whole ceremony out of shelling gungo. Me no shell gungo because I feel a worm. So me no touch it. But that was another experience, and good morning, no man. Christmas morning, now them meet the where season 2 days and all that, you know, in a yabba and sinting them and come out and in a pot and the bride, the gungo in the coconut, queen of the coconut juice a bubble. Me tell you something, you see, the whole environment, the whole community smell of various pots and various seasoning and galang, you know. Them, the same thing, they smell nice and lovely. And the Christmas carol, them appear on the radio. Our summer, we will. We never really have radio, radio fusion. We did have a radio fusion. The only one man in the community did have a radio fusion. And up our back yard, you would have get. You hear me? But you hear carols and everything, man. Please sing it. Nice and thing, and some of the old drunk at them in the community, then get up from early morning, you know, and then start to walk, treat and I drink the Sorrel and the white rum and it's in there. I'll buy 11 o'clock to see some of them. A roadside dog, I lick them out. Yes, we love that, we love that, we love that. We love them, the Christmas, the carefree, nothing in the world to bother you. Yes, man, and people sharing, people moving from house to house, and them are walking them because something and all like that. Then now you have the Christmas cake, or as we call it, you know, Christmas pudding. Yes, but that was, it was real pudding because some of the people, them, I know some women who bake and them boil it, you know, so that a pudding. And so some of them are total, them make and call the Christmas cake. We don't know where they come from. Them couldn't make it. But them are try because they made them couldn't afford to buy one cake or so. You know what I mean? Because as to know, nowadays cake expensive, very expensive. Yes, man. One little slice of Christmas pudding and that was it. Some people, and I am speaking from my experience, you know, because we never had it. We were poor, I mean, and I'm saying poor here, not feeling ashamed or anything, right? It was the way of life. And in our community, really and truly, we never realized that we were poor because everybody helped and everybody took care of the children. So there was food, and you could go to the neighbor's house and you eat also. So we never feel anyway. But now, the Sorrel, remember Sorrel, Lord, a massive man. The Sorrel come in, wagga wagga, and people boil them Sorrel and then mix it with the ginger and some pimento art, and really with the white rum, and some people put wine in there and it strong and nice, and some buckle it and put it all for the next year. When you get that, you say, man, ooh, wow, the spirit turn up in the trunk. So we always have that. Now, in a Christmas, you know, everything has to be spick and span. So them clean the house, clean, man, house clean, wax, house dust, straw. That you use the straw, that you rub the floor, you use your wax, your beeswax, you rub the coconut brush pan it, and you know, you use the beeswax and rub pan the coconut brush, and you rub your floor, and you knock Johnny Cooper. And when you not got no beeswax, you light a little tinning lamp. Oh, no, remember those things? You light a little tinning lamp, man, and you get your piece of candy to melt the candy and rub it pan the brush, man, and you gone back to your floor cleaning. Oh Lord, such lovely, lovely days. And the thing when them say you nap Johnny Copper is a rhythm that you play on the floor with the brush. But who is Johnny Copper? Anybody know? And let me tell you something, man. One of the things that me know say my mother always do is eggnog. Eggnog pan Christmas morning. Me don't know where she did get that incident from because we didn't pour the cow. But she always give me eggnog in the morning. And then it's Jonkonnu. Jonkonnu. Uno remember Jonkonnu? Yes, man. Jonkonnu come out. Pick enough of with it free the Jonkonnu, you know, because the costumes are really, really well done. And them have the asset and the devil and the belly woman and them the character they afraid of them, you know. And guess what? They were all men performing these roles. And let me tell you, them they said in there when you hear drum a beat, and nice, wonderful music. And let me tell you, that was Christmas. And I sometimes wish that all those things could come back, but it is not so. Christmas tree, people take color paper and then wrap around whatever they could have wrapped around and call it Christmas tree, and then put empty box wrapping and all kind of color paper, and then put your brother and say, Santa, come. Me never forget one night me try to sleep out Santa, but I know me not see Santa yet. So, folks, wonderful people, up there in Leeds, I hope this jog your memory as to the beautiful Christmases that you used to experience right here in the Caribbean. I thank you so much for listening, and may God bless you all, and know that Leeds is one of my very, very special place. Enjoy this Christmas, and let the thoughts of the Caribbean keep you through this winter season. God bless you. Lots of love.